on a topic today that I'll bet very few of you have done. Orthodontic extrusion. What the heck is that? Dave Wright from Michigan. How many years have you been practicing?
30 years.
30 years. Yeah. And when did you get into orthodontic orientation?
About 10 years in, so it's been close to 20 years now.
Yeah. So you've had good experience. I have had experiences with the need for orthodontic extrusion quite a few times. A kid knocked off all these anterior teeth with an elbow in basketball, long roots. I'd like you to tell this group why you think this is a valuable technique for any general practitioner.
Boy, it's a great technique. It's not something you use a lot, but when you have that patient come in and they're a healthy dentition, periodontally, endodontically, there's not a problem with the tooth. It could be endodontically treated or not. But if the dentition is in good shape and it's fractured right off at the alveolar crest, well, what are you going to do? You have no sound tooth structure.
No.
Forget about biological width. You can crown lengthen, but if you're doing that on a front tooth, it's going to look crazy.
Oh, yeah, have a big cyclop tooth sticking up.
Nowadays, a lot of times we're thinking, well, extract and immediate implant, and I do that. But there's, I've been doing implants for a while now, too, and I'm starting to appreciate that teeth are good.
I have a statement that I'll stand on. There's nothing like a tooth.
Yeah.
The implant's nice. I've been doing them 30 plus years, but I'd like to retain that tooth. How long does it take to pull a tooth down? Let's take one central incisor, and you want to pull it down into place.
Yeah, if sound dentition elsewhere and the other teeth are fairly aligned, about 8 weeks.
About 8 weeks.
Yeah, now you can do it two different ways, and not to get beyond what we want to talk about today, but if the gingival levels are all appropriate, you can extract it fast, and you won't bring the soft and hard tissue with it. If you have a little bit of a higher gingiva on that and you want to bring it down, you go a little bit slower and you'll be more likely to bring some hard and soft tissue with it.
How long of a root would you like to have? Take a typical central incisor, which is about 1/3 crown. How much root would you really have to have? Because a lot of kids who have had orthodontics have had they've had shortened roots.
Sure they have, yeah. I want to end up at the end of it once I, let's say we're going to bring it out 4 millimeters. I want to make sure that we still have a crown to root ratio at least 1:1.
Okay, perfect. You got that. Mm-hmm. All right. And how long would you wait for stability to occur?
I usually get them in a temp. I prep everything, get in a temp, and I wait about 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
Now, other people will say wait longer. It's been my experience that about 2 weeks it seems pretty stable.
Okay,
now,
so you have a temporary on, and if it's going to start to intrude again, you're going to see it.
Oh, yeah. So, you have a tooth fractured flat to the, alveolar crest. You're going to do a post-encore. If it doesn't have endo, you're going to do endo. If it had endo, but bacteria got up into there, you're going to, redo the endo. Mm-hmm. So you have a fresh endo. Do a post-encore, but I might take a half round and create some little divots in the existing tooth, but you only can get to so much. You don't really want to lay a flap to do this because you want to leave the tissue intact. But then as you erupt it down, if your margin isn't real nice and perfect on that post-encore, you'll have a chance later on to smooth that off and create. But that post-encore is what you'll use to put your bracket on and erupt this down and out. Two or three teeth on either side with brackets. And you're good to go.
What have you seen as negatives? Have you had gingival irritation? Have you had lack of healing? What have you had?
No, gingiva gets better as the tooth is erupted out because then you have recreating your biological width. So not a problem there. The only real downside, if everything is there, if you have good dentition, good perio, that kind of thing, is a patient that doesn't want brackets on their teeth. But frankly, I don't think I've ever run into anyone that said no, because it's 8 to 10 weeks. And most people are, you say, hey, these are the fees if I'm going to extract, do immediate implant, graft, all this sort of stuff, and this is the fee if I save the tooth. And, it's a lot of times patients will say, well, that I'd rather save my tooth.
Would you normally have to do a post-encore and a build-up on one that you're extruding?
Always. Because
that's a point you need.
It's fractured flat to the alveolar crest.
So you just don't have enough coronal tooth structure.
So you build up, and I typically will leave the tooth as short. I'll leave the incisal edge in my post-encore to be short, so when I get it all the way down so it's level with the others, we're good to go.
Okay, one more point. not in dollars, but in proportionate. A crown, let's say today is around $1,000 or $1,100. What would a typical orthodontic fee in proportion to that be?
In my office, because I do a lot of ortho, it's easy to do. Yeah. I have the stuff. My staff is trained. They do much of it. Half to two-thirds a crown.
Okay.
Yeah.
Did that influence you? Next time you have a patient come in and about half of the males, by the time they're age 6, have had a fractured tooth. Some of them have popped off the tooth right at the bone line. Next time they come in, think about Dave and think about orthodontic extrusion. Thanks for being with us today.
Thank you.
Thanks for being with us. Join us next week.